I am Dr. Chandrika Shekhar, working as an obstetrician and gynecologist in Chirag Hospital and Maternity Center, JP Nagar, second phase. I am also going as a visiting consultant at Manithi Manipal Hospital, Jayanagar 9th block, and Apollo Cradle Hospital, Jayanagar 5th block. I do visit Motherhood Hospital in Banashankari, second stage also. Coming to endometrial thickness, what I would advise you people is, don't go too much into the anatomy or physiology without knowing things. Because any problem that you face, you can go and see your doctor so that they'll take care of you. Because there is so many things about endometrium which we will have studied as medical graduates. So about endometrial thickness, no, it tries to vary. That is the reason I have kept this chart to explain for you. So it varies in different phases of the women's cycle, and it also varies in the different phases of the life of a woman. So it will be different in a youngster, it will be different in a young lady, it will be different in a menopausal lady. It's like that. See, routinely what happens is, all our body system, that is the genital system in a female, it depends on the release of the sex hormones. Every lady will have two types of sex hormones. One is the estrogen and the other is the progesterone. So depending on the levels of these hormones, it will take care of the whole genital system. So depending on that levels, the endometrial thickness will be varying. Okay, so when the particular lady starts her menstrual cycle, its whole cycle is a 1 month cycle. 1 month months, it may be 30 days, it may be 28 days. So it will be little variation between each individual. Okay, so every one cycle means one menstrual cycle. So there is change of all the endometrial thickness, whole of the cycle it will be changing. So initially when the cycle is starting, the estrogen hormone is secreted from the ovaries. So when estrogen starts coming in the blood, it tries to grow the thickness of the lining of the uterus. See, this lining only I have shown here, okay? So this one will come here, okay? This is the thickness of the lining of the uterus. So whenever a lady is menstruating, this is a menstruating endometrium. Lining of the uterus is called as endometrium, okay? So whenever a lady sets in menses, no? So that time there is a bleeding happening, and this thickness of this endometrium, no, it is shed. That is what happens in a menstrual cycle. So whenever she menstruates, it gets shed, all the tissues also fall, and it starts bleeding also, and it will become so thin. Okay, and once the menstruation is over, then her hormone levels start changing. The ovary starts secreting what is called as estrogen, and when the estrogen level raises, it acts as a fertilizer for the endometrium to grow. So this one which has become like this after menstruation, so thin, then it starts becoming slowly thicker and thicker and thicker. So once it reaches maximum secretion, that is usually after 2 weeks of the menstruation, the maximum level of the estrogen is reached. So that time the maximum thickness of the endometrium happens. I have told you that lining of the uterus is called as endometrium. So at the end of the 2 weeks, it will go to this thickness. So that time that vascularity of the layer is also more, and the growth is also maximum. So when it suddenly, if it starts menstruating, it will cause heavy bleeding. So how nature has made is, once the egg is released, that time the phase of the hormones will change. That is, after the release of the egg, the ovaries start secreting a hormone called as progesterone. So it will act counter to the effect of estrogen. So it will start trying to control the extra growth of the endometrium. So once it is controlled, it will come under control of the progesterone. So the one which has grown wildly with full of blood vessels, that is all controlled to a certain extent, it is specified. So it will stagnate at one level, it will reach the next 2 weeks. And once the next 2 weeks happens, both the hormones, that is estrogen and progesterone, they stop secretion from the ovaries. So once that stimulation from the ovary stops, that time there is no stimulus to hold this layer called endometrium. Once that stops, then it will have no manure. So once that is withdrawn, they cannot stand. So that time they start bleeding, and they start shedding this layer. And again it comes to here. That is the menstruation which happens. With the bleeding, some tissues are also shed, and again they come to this. This is a cycle of uterus that happens in any lady, okay? So about the thickness of the endometrium, there are certain thicknesses at each phase. So you need not bother about your head about the thickness of the endometrium, because any problem you have, you go to your doctor, she will look after, okay? So that one particular thickness is there, and some people, there is over stimulation of this hormone called estrogen. So those are the people which go to very thick levels. And very thick levels, naturally they will start bleeding more once the withdrawal happens. So those are the people who land in heavy bleeding when the menstruation happens. So that heavy bleeding, as I told you, there is unnecessary loss of blood which makes the lady weak, and so she faces problems in all the things, one commonest thing is anemia. So those things you can go to the doctor and they'll tackle it. And one more thing about this thickness, most important thing is, whenever people come with heavy bleeding, if there is unregulated flow of estrogen, that is, we call it cystoglandular hyperplasia in our medical terms. So there is unregulated, that is, only estrogen is secreting. So when the estrogen secretion becomes too much, it can grow to so much overgrowth that it may herald the onset of endometrial cancer, that is, a cancer of the uterus. So that is the only the problem about the endometrial thickness, that is the problem. One thing is that one. Second thing is, when in younger ladies, when you are going to conceive, if this thickness is not enough, the baby that is produced in the tubes cannot nidate in the uterus, means it cannot settle in the uterus and grow properly if the thickness of the endometrium is very thin. So depending on the problems involved, the doctor will tackle it with proper treatment. That is the danger of the endometrial, that is the importance of endometrial thickness. So if it is too thick also, it is problematic. If it is too thin also, it is problematic. So too thin is problematic in people who are going for fertility treatments, and too thick is a problem in the perimenopausal age group, when the chances of malignancy are more, that is, chances of uterine cancer are more. So too much thick is also not good, too much thin is also not good. That is the thing you have to know about the thickness of the endometrium.